Welcome everyone. So here, now we are with fraction of multiplication and division. I hope you have watched my previous videos of addition and subtraction of fraction. Now begin with multiplication of fraction. Multiply fractions. There are some steps to multiply the fraction. Step 1. Multiply the numerators. From each of the numerators means numbers on the top. The result of the numerator of the answer. Then step 2. Multiply the denominators of each fraction by each other. The numbers on the bottom. The result is the denominator of the answer. Now simplify or reduce the answer. Here is one example of multiplying fraction. 2 upon 5 multiply by 6 upon 7. So here the numerators are 2 and 6. We shall multiply this. 2 multiply 6 is equal to 12. Now we shall multiply denominators 5 and 7. 5 sevens are 35. So here the answer is 12 upon 35. So here we are with another example of multiplying fraction. Multiply the numerators of the fraction. The fraction here is 2 upon 5. Multiply 3 upon 7. We shall multiply 2 multiply 3, both the numerator, that is 6. We shall place there. Similarly, multiply the denominators together, that is 5 and 7. 5 7 are 35. So here the answer is 6 upon 35. It's very easy, students. Now we shall take another example to check this. If we have many fractions, what we shall do? Here is another example. 2 upon 3 multiply 6 upon 8 multiply 1 upon 2. What we shall do? Guess yourself. We shall solve. Yes, we shall solve it in this manner. First step we shall take, calculate the product of the numerator, that are 2 and 6 and 1. 2 multiply 6 multiply 1 is equal to 12. Then denominators 3 multiply 8 multiply 2, that is 48. So we shall get that 12 upon 48. It can be reduced, so we shall reduce it. Hope you are able to understand. Now here we are with another example, that is 3 upon 10 multiply 5 upon 4 multiply 8 upon 9. We shall multiply all the numerators, that are 3, 5 and 8. That gives the answer 120. And multiply all denominators, that is 10, 4 and 9, that will give the answer 360. So we shall reduce this, that will give 120, 1 ja 120, 123 ja 360. So we shall reduce the answer, will be 1 upon 3. I hope you are able to understand. Now here we are with the example of the fraction. In this, one fraction has 5 only. Numerator, that we shall count numerator and there is no denominator. So what we shall do with that? 5 multiply 2 upon 15. When you multiply a whole number to a fraction, think of the whole number as a fraction with a denominator of 1. Since 1 is equal to 5 upon 1, denominator is 5. Denominator is 1. So let us solve this now. Now we shall solve the fraction without denominator, that is an integer, the whole number. We can rewrite the original problem, that is 5 upon 1 multiplied 2 upon 15. So we have got it very easy. We shall multiply the numerators and then multiply the denominators. After that we shall get the answer 10 upon 50. Finally we shall reduce the answer by dividing the numerator and denominator by 5. That will give us the answer 2 upon 3. Isn't it right? Isn't it very easy? Yes, it is. Here, again, the next type of multiplication is that if we get mixed numbers and we need to multiply. Mixed numbers, like there is one integer and the fraction, like 1 upon 3. Multiply by 5 upon 6. What shall we do? First step is this. We will change to an improper fraction. Mixed fraction to an improper fraction. That will give the answer 3 1s are 3 plus 1 is equal to 4 upon 3. Okay, then we shall multiply numerators together and multiply denominators together. Multiply across, change the improper fraction to a mixed number if you get the answer in improper fraction. There is one example, that is 1 3 upon 4 multiply 2 1 upon 2. So firstly we shall convert it into improper fraction. We can see here with the black color written 1 multiply 4 plus 3 is equal to 7 and 2 multiply 2 plus 1 is equal to 5. So we will get the improper fraction, that is 7 upon 4 multiply 5 upon 2 is equal to 7 5 is 35, 4 2 is 8. We got improper fraction, that is 35 upon 8. So we shall turn it to mixed fraction, that I have told in the earlier video also how to divide and how to find the integer. The question we get is the integer. The remainder is numerator and the dividend is, divisor is your denominator. One more thing is here to be very clear about shortcut, cancelling the numbers. If we get the multiplication that we can cancel earlier only without multiplying, before that we can cancel that. Like before multiplying, if we can cut numerator or denominator, both are coming in the same table, we can cut that. Like 3 and 15, one is numerator, another is denominator, are coming in the table of 3. So we shall divide it by 3. 3 1s are 3, 3 5s are 15. Same as 4 1s are 4, 4 2s are 8. Then we shall multiply the denominators, multiply the numerators. Okay, we shall get the answer 2 1s are 2, 2 upon 5. In this way, multiplication will be very easy to us to do. Mainly if there are big numbers given to you. So let us practice more about multiplication. Let us make it more easy after cancelling first and then after multiply. First one here is 3 upon 5 multiply 1 upon 3. There is 3 is as numerator, 3 as denominator. So we shall reduce this. 3 1s are 3, 3 1s are 3. And we are left with numerator as 1 and denominator as 5. So here answer will be 1 upon 5. Same as is next, 2 upon 5 multiply 5 upon 10. 5 as numerator, 5 as denominator. We shall cancel 5 in the 5, 5 in the 5. Then 2 is left and 10 is left 2 as numerator, 10 as denominator. So we shall cancel it 2 also. 2 in the 2, 2 5 is 10. So here we are left with 1 upon 5. Same as the next examples, you can try on your own. I hope you are able to understand it properly. It's very easy. You will not find any problem. You will enjoy doing this. But one thing is, concept should be very, very clear to you. Now, here we are with dividing the fraction. Dividing fraction is very similar to multiplying fraction. You even use multiplication. The one change is that you have to take the reciprocal of the divide of the number given to you of the fraction. That is, if it is 2 upon 3, we will convert it into 3 upon 2. Then you proceed with the problem just as if you were multiplying. So step 1 is take the reciprocal of the divisor. Next is multiply the numerators as we have done multiplication, multiply denominators and then simplify the answer. First and foremost thing is, while dividing, take the reciprocal. Denominator will be numerator and numerator will be at the place of denominator. Is that clear? Now dividing the fractions. To divide fractions, take the reciprocal. First thing is, take reciprocal. 4 upon 5 divide 2 upon 3. Whose reciprocal we shall take? The next one fraction. 4 upon 5 we shall copy and make reciprocal of 2 upon 3, that will be 3 upon 2. So here we shall get the fractions 4 upon 5 multiply 3 upon 2. Multiply the numerators and multiply the denominators. 12 upon 10. Yes, we have to simplify this. This is, while simplifying, firstly we shall divide 2 6 is 12, 2 5 is 10, and then after dividing, we shall get a mixed fraction, that is 1 1 upon 5. So here is one example for you. 2 upon 5 divide by 2 upon 3. What was the first step? Take the reciprocal of the divisor. What is divisor? 2 upon 3. What we shall do in it? 3 upon 2. So here we shall get the fractions 2 upon 5 multiply 3 upon 2. Multiply numerator, then multiply denominator. We got 6 upon 10. Then what we shall do? We shall simplify this. We shall reduce it while cancelling. 2 3 is 6, 2 5 is 10 is equal to 3 upon 5. Another example here is 4 upon 7 divide by 2, but there is no denominator written. What shall we do? We shall take denominator 1. So here we shall get 4 upon 7 divide 2 upon 1. Reciprocal of 2 upon 1 is 1 upon 2. So we shall multiply numerator, multiply denominator, we shall get the answer 4 upon 14. We shall reduce it to, that will give the answer to us 2 upon 7. Isn't it very easy? Yes, you are feeling to do it very easy, but the only thing to remember is take a reciprocal. So here are some more examples to practice to you. Division sums are given. Take reciprocal, multiply and then get the answer. If it is need to reduce or simplify, do it. Clear? Now in the end, here is an activity. Take 6 paper stripes of equal length. Fold them in 2, 3, 4, 6, 8, 12 in equal parts. Write fraction on each part as shown below. And make your activity very interesting and attractive with the use of different color stripes. And review that, try to compare that, what is it. Use this model to rewrite and add as one is done for you. Now, I hope you all will find it very easy to multiply the fractions or divide the fractions. It's very easy. Thank you. Do not forget to like, subscribe and share. Subscribe my channel to find the videos at the earliest. Thank you. Have a nice time.